So dear student, as I am designing this now, this inside color also you can give. See here, go to this inside color portion. You can give the inside color of it. Suppose inside color yellow. This one, if you select this one, then this one inside color also you can give any color, whatever inside color you want. You can give the inside color, isn't it? So similarly, you can design this also. I am designing this one for you. I am bringing it here. The alignment. Now I am making it in the middle. I am making the changing the color, alphabet color of it. Suppose I am making it green, and background color, suppose I am giving it yellow, okay. And this one also I am selecting. First you have to select it, then you bring it in the grid. Wherever the grid is there, you can make it little bit large or bigger. Okay, now you make it in the middle portion, give the font color red, background color I am giving here, suppose another background color I am applying, this is little bit blackish color, this color I am giving so that you can understand. So this is the thing. Now see here, this particular thing you can give the label. Okay, label means what? You select this label box. As soon as you select this label box, you click here. After clicking here, suppose you write here student detail. I am making it cap, STUDENTS, students, DETAILS, details, student details. After you write it, then click outside, then you select it. After selecting it, then you make it in the middle. You can increase the font size. Suppose font size 14, you can make it. You can make it bold. Okay, you can make it bold. Any type of designing you can give here. So you can give the background color of it and font color, suppose red is good, and background color I am giving yellow so that it will be prominent. Okay, thing is that this is a way. Now here in this particular background, you can implement the background, lot of background. See here, the background, you can fill the background with a color. You can fill the background with a color, or you can bring the other details in the background. You can use the charts. So these all are not there, though of all. So I am not going to all these details. This chart also you can create here. So suppose I am giving the background. See here, boundary frame. If you want, you can give color. If you press on it, you can give the color also. Suppose background color is given green. But this color is not so good, so I'm changing the color. Which color? Blue. Okay, violet. Let me select the violet color. Any pattern of color. Suppose this color. If it is done, okay. So this is done. What happened? Now you have to save it. Suppose this is finished. More designing is not required. You are not want to do any more designing. So you have to finish this. Okay. So how to finish it? There. You cross in this particular button. Do you want to save? Yes. Form 1, okay. Okay, so see here, student 1, it's form 1. So form 1, you click on the form 1, see the data. If you click the there, see there is a next record. Click on the next record, the thing will going to change. Okay, all the thing, address and student roll number is changing. So this is how you can make it. Okay, next one, I want to make the what you have a form I have made. Now I am going to make a report with the help of wizard, report with the help of the design view. So how to create a report? Go to in this section, see here, report in a design view, report with the wizards. First with the wizard report. Again I am selecting some value. Suppose I am selecting roll number, I am selecting the first name, I am selecting the address. Okay, you can select all, but I am selecting only 3 values. You can understand the thing. After the designing and total is depend on you. Next, okay, next, what pattern of report? This way you want to do. If you want to change anything, then you can change it. The thing will come in this way. Okay, now next means ascending order, descending order. If you want to arrange it, you do. I am not going to do. It will come in as per the order it is there. Okay. Then you are going to next in a tabular format, in the portal format, in the column format, in the justified format, whatever the format you want, because there is a case of printing purposes there. So you can use it. I am just giving it in a tabular format. Okay. So after tabular format, then you go to the next. Now, how you give it? See here, the different types of follow up is there.